First of all, I would like to give a big thanks to the Fiji Football Federation for giving me the opportunity to coach the Fiji national team. I'd like to thank for the very warm welcome I've had from Mr. Patel, from Mr. Yusuf, from Mr. Kumar, and from the clubs that I have visited until now. We have actually visited until now 3 clubs, and I've had a very good meeting from the beginning with those clubs. As I said, I'm very proud and I'm honored to be given the responsibility of taking care of the Fiji national team. It's actually, for me, the most you can achieve is to be a national team head coach. Taking care of the biggest talents and players in the country where you perform. I can assure I'll do my best to improve the level of Fijian football. Not only for the national men's team, but for all national teams, women and men's. Talent development has always had a big place in my heart, and I'll really try to do my best to be part of developing players as well, boys and girls in this country. Besides that, during my spell as head coach in different places, I have very often been asked by UEFA to do coaching courses on behalf of UEFA, and it was actually the reason that I learned this region to know, because 2015 I was asked by UEFA if I could go and support the OFC by their first A-license course. And I was there, and I actually there also for the first time met our technical director, Ramines Kumar, and we have actually more or less been a bit in contact since that course, and very much up to my nomination as national team head coach here of Fiji. So coach education has also a big place in my heart. Of course, I cannot do everything at the same time, but I hope I'll be able to inspire as well in the talent development as in the coach education. And who knows, maybe Fiji would be the next country to host an A-licensed coach education. I would be proud on behalf of Fiji and on behalf of the OFC if they would be so kind to place the next A-licensed course here. And of course, I would do my best to help out there. My knowledge of Fijian football actually comes from my spell as national team head coach in PND. It was 2016. We were not in the same group as Fiji, but I watched all 3 matches that Fiji played in this tournament. And I feel like I maybe did in PND, that I'm able to raise the level of football here and also raise the level of the national team. It's really my my aim to bring Fiji football and Fiji national team to a higher level. Maybe you think I'm a bit crazy when I'm saying what I'm saying now, but my aim is actually to bring Fiji to be the best team in the region, New Zealand included. I feel that too many times the island countries are a bit too afraid when they face New Zealand. They show a bit too much respect for them. But actually, their level of football is not higher than the level, for example, in Fiji. So my job, one of the jobs will be actually to give the players here more self-confidence when they face stronger opponents. Never be afraid of anyone. Respect every team you meet, but never be afraid of anyone. In football, everything is possible. I'm also
happy to come to a federation or association who has had such a long cooperation with one main sponsor, Vodafone. It actually gives me a lot of confidence that I'm coming to an association where the conditions are stable. And as far as I know, you have been, I think William told me, you have been the main sponsor for Fiji FA for 12 years. Yeah, it's a very long period, but for me, it's a very good sign that Fiji FA is able to keep a main sponsor for such a long time. To the media, we will have an open-minded, we will be open-minded in the national team. You'll be invited to all trainings and, of course, matches. But I can already now tell you that it'll be like this. When we're in the camp with the national team, before every training, the media will have the first 15 minutes to interview players or coaches, whatever it might be. After 15 minutes, you can stay there and watch the training, but there'll be no interviews after the training. But you'll have 15 minutes every day we're in the camp. There's only one day that we will have no media. It's the day before the match. It's I'm sure you have been used to this here also. But otherwise, we will be very open-minded. What I'll try to do, and I hope you can hear me, already is on my way to do together with Mr. Ravines Kumar, is actually that I'll visit all Premier League clubs to have the close cooperation with them from the beginning, because they are the clubs that are delivering the players for the national teams. So it's necessary to have a good cooperation there. We will also, before we have the first camp, we will try to have a meeting with all clubs, most likely in Bar, I could imagine, where Mr. Ravines Kumar and I will give, so to say, our rules, the way we will be working. I'll go on the pitch on a one-day course and show them, for example, what exercises we will be using with the national team, hopefully to inspire the clubs to have a similar playing style philosophy. When I'm saying having a similar playing style philosophy, it has nothing to do with whether you play 4-4-2 or 4-3-3 or 3-5-2 or what it might be, but a philosophy about how you want to play football. At the end, I would like to say I'm looking forward to cooperation with everybody here in Fiji involved in football, because in my opinion, we are part, all of us here, we are part of the world's best game. Thank you very much.